Nancy, it had all the makings of a thriller down in South Beach. A lot of fun highlights. Landry Shamet with a tremendous performance off the bench. But unfortunately for Brooklyn, they will remember what happened right at the tail end of regulation. Bam Adebayo taking matters into his own hands. Last second situation where Adebayo gets the bucket. Miami gets the win.
Yeah, and I think overall throughout the course of that fourth quarter, you started to see some momentum build, and you felt like the Nets were figuring things out, in particular on the offensive end, finding shots, but also defensively, getting some stops, starting to secure the glass. In those final few possessions, the ball stops moving on the offensive end. You're not getting the quality looks that you were throughout the course of the game that allowed you to be so efficient from the field. And then Bam Adebayo, I mean, that is a clutch bucket, but a smart play of just putting him in isolation and allowing him to go to work, come through. And Brooklyn, again, go back to film of all of the little things and the details and the areas that have been issues for them throughout the course of the season, whether it's turning the basketball over, second chance opportunities, trying to find ways to shore up the defense. A lot of those once again surface for this group against a Miami team that came in very hungry to find their way back into a win column.
8-0 run for Miami to end the fourth quarter. Kyrie Irving certainly tried to take over at times in the final minutes and just could not make a shot. The positives for Brooklyn, the bench, led by Landry Shamet, a new career high for him. The confidence that has been oozing out of Landry Shamet, well, we saw it all on display, not just the three-pointers, but going hard to the rim and playing with a great deal of conviction.
Big picture, this is really critical for the Nets. And first of all, you really are proud of the way Landry Shamet, with the tough start to the season and how he struggled from the field, has consistently been improving. But to your point, Ian, the three-point shooting, the efficiency and accuracy has been tremendous to see. That, I think, is what we expect out of his game. It's all the other things that he has brought to the table. And in particular, with this Nets group, down James Harden, down Tyler Johnson, down Chris Chioza, you need someone to be able to come in and run the second unit and be a ball handler. And I think just what we saw out of Landry throughout the course of this game and how he was being aggressive looking for his shots, but also just able to organize and run the offense, is really important and bodes well for the role that he can play and fill in different circumstances as the season continues.
And down Kevin Durant, just 4 minutes of action, a thigh bruise for Durant. They'll monitor that situation. And now coming up, another one on the road. It's New Orleans. Another desperate team trying to stay in a playoff chase right now. They had a crushing loss to the New York Knicks, and the Nets will get a first-hand look at Zion Williamson. They handled them the last time these two teams matched up.
Though he is someone who, talk about efficiency, has been just an absolute beast in how he's been able to score, the move by Stan Van Gundy, putting him at the point guard position to initiate the offense, and a lot of the pieces that New Orleans has been able to fill the gaps with, Brandon Ingram, they're a team that can be dangerous, and they haven't quite figured it out or fit it together, but the Nets are going to have their hands full when they go to New Orleans. You said a crushing loss against the Knicks, so you anticipate that they will come back with a lot of motivation as they're still trying to find their place in the playoff standings. But for Brooklyn, a lot of it is going to be interesting to see the next couple of games, James Harden's status, when he may be inching closer to a return, and what it looks like for Kevin Durant when he may be able to take the floor again.
First game of a three-game road trip, and it goes in the loss column for Brooklyn at the buzzer. Miami, a winner.